in many the attitude and the behavior intention of patients with aortic dissection on access-based rehabilitation. Based on this theme, I further carried out a study to understand the impact of access-based rehabilitation on patients with aortic dissection and wrote a scoping review. Now I will describe it in detail in the last oral report. My presentation includes four parts. To begin with, I will explain the background to do this research. Then I will describe my research methods in detail. Last of all, I will summarize my presentation, which is about the research results and the discussion. Now, let me introduce the background. As we all know, aortic dissection is a pathologic change that the blood in the aortic cavity enters the aortic media from the aortic intima tear and depends along the long axis of the water, resulting in the separation of the true and false aortic cavities is a series of with the characteristics of sudden onset, rapid progress, and high mortality. In recent years, the survival rate of AD has improved. However, the quality of life of AD patients is not ideal. Their psychosocial and lower function are decreased. Also, the growing number of survivors is usually younger. They have doubles of about lifestyle, return to normal physical activity, and even exercise. Therefore, too many physical restrictions will have a huge impact on their daily life. Cardiac rehabilitation as a comprehensive and coordinated long-term play, including medical evaluation, access cardiac rehabilitation, physiological prescription, patient health education and consultation, nutrition prescription. The exercise-based cardiac rehabilitation ECR is the core. ECR can lower blood pressure, delay the development of atherosclerosis, reduce the occurrence of cardiac events, control risk factors, promote mental health, improve the quality of life, and improve the progress. Nevertheless, the recommendation for type and the intensity of ECR for patients with AD still represents a dilemma. Therefore, our group conducted a scoping review of the literature on AD access rehabilitation. The key aims of this scoping review were to provide evidence for ECR so as to better improve the prognosis of patients and improve the quality of life after discharge. Let's take a look at the research methods. We use five framework. Step one, identify the research question. One, what are the measurement indexes of ECR for AD? Two, what are the support types of ECR for AD? Three, what is the safety and the effectiveness of ECR for AD? Step two, identify relevant studies. Research department, IBOS, MedLife, Web of Science, Clinical Library, Wanfang Chinese Database, Zhiwang Chinese Database, and Clinical Trials Registry. This is the process of searching on PubMed. The keywords are aortic dissection and access rehabilitation. Step three, study selection. The inclusion criteria are researching articles that include patients with AD, studies that carried on the ECR, studies that included corresponding observation indexes, and published in English or Chinese, and including trials registry in clinical trials registry. Publication date and the research type were no restriction. The inclusion criteria are intervention content such as therapeutic measures, unable to get full test article. Studies were reviewed or mental analysis. Studies were repeated. All relevant papers published up to February 2021 were retrieved. Save for starting the data, the following data were extracted and classified. Each individual study for the author, year and country of publication, study type, time, and location for taking ECR, measuring evaluation indexes, may types, study purpose, the progress of ECR, summary of results, and main conclusion. Save five, collecting, summarizing, and reporting the results. A total of 1,684 records were found by searching and the database and the clinical trial registry. 138 duplicated records were deleted, and 11 records made the inclusion criteria according to the screening process. The screening process is showing in the right figure. Later, I will introduce the research results from the following experts. One, describe the articles. We summarize the characteristics of the articles, including case study, cohort, randomized controlled trial. The picture on the left shows the country of publication of the article. The figure on the right shows the year of publication of the article. Two, evaluation indexes of ECR. The evaluation of indexes of patients with AD after participating in ECR could be divided into four parts, including indicators reflecting cardiopulmonary function, reflecting adverse events, reflecting hospital cleaning costs, and reflecting psychosocial function. Main types of ECR. The main types of ECR for patients with AD, including early activities, aerobic exercise, resistance exercise, flexibility exercise, and coordinated exercise. For summary of studies included in this review, the study showed light resources of ECR for patients with AD, which were described from three aspects, including the purpose of study, the effectiveness of ECR, and the safety of exercise. We also found two studies from the Chinese clinical trial registry. Although the research has not yet been complicated, the purpose of is also to evaluate the effectiveness and the safety of early basket training, as well as early rehabilitation. The intervention context of rehabilitation includes early mobilization, cycling, cardiopulmonary rehabilitation by psychosocial therapist. The last part is the discussion and the conclusion. I will cover the discussion part in five parts. Only 11 eligible studies were included in this scoping review. The publication time of these articles were relatively new. Randomized controlled trials were few. However, we also found that the recent literature on this topic are gradually increasing, and the clinical trial registry center has also carried out qualitative research on this aspect, which shows that the ECR of patients with AD is more and more concerned by the medical community and is a topic worthy of study. Implementation of observation indexes. This scoping review divided the evaluation indexes of ECR into the following aspects. Adverse events, indicators reflecting cardiopulmonary function, psychosocial function. The three parts is multiply outcome criterion score standard. Four, in hospital cleaning costs. However, there is still a lack of systematic management indexes for the rehabilitation of AD. This aspect needs to be future studied by research in the future. Standards clinical exercise rehabilitation pathway. The types of exercise include aerobic exercise, independence exercise, flexibility exercise, and coordination exercise. Special support that patients in AD can maintain normal physical and sexual activities. Including lifting weights to 50% of body weight as well as daily activities. So then recommend patients perform mild moderate activities and avoid heavy daily activity. Channel encourage patients with AD to take moderate intensive aerobic exercise for is not more than 30 minutes and at least 150 minutes per week. CPET is a method of objectively and quantitatively assessing cardiorespiratory disease form. And due to the particularity of AD group, having the characteristics of sudden onset, repeated progress, and high mortality for those older patients with underlying disease, even if they are screened comprehensively before trialing, it's still possible that unexpected complications occur. So we should take the four parts. So finally, I will introduce the conclusion. This review has proven the safety and the effectiveness of ECR for patients with AD. Our results should promote future research in three aspects. One, systematic evaluation indicators and standards clinical exercise rehabilitation pathway. Two, more randomized controlled trials. Three, more assessment methods such as CPET. This is the reference. This is all my presentation. Thank you for your attention.
That was an excellent